Now, Modupe Enyinla is a beauty consultant and a mom blogger and the co-founder of iMomZone, which is a platform for pregnant new moms and moms to toddlers, to share their motherhood experiences. Now, we're here to talk about shy toddlers and how to warm them up, get them to express themselves more.
Yes.
Welcome back to the show.
Thank you for having me again.
All right. So now, as a parent myself, what should I look out for to, you know, find out if my toddler is actually a shy toddler? Let's start from there.
Okay, so the thing is, shy toddlers are always very chatty at home.
Okay.
They tend to be very warm with people in the house and all. Mm. But then at events, at gatherings, they get clingy. Mm. That's always the very first thing.
Okay.
They won't want to leave your side.
Okay.
And therefore, you won't even enjoy the event or gathering. So they're always very clingy. Then they don't warm up to people easily. Okay. They find it very hard to warm up to kids or even adults.
Okay. So you notice that they always shy away from going to meet other adults?
Yes, yes. Okay. They'll sit at the spot for as long as the event will hold. And
so it's not a bad thing to be shy, right?
Well, it's not, because research has actually shown that 15% of babies are born shy.
Okay.
Yes, so it's now up to we parents to make sure that these kids don't stay shy.
Okay.
Because at the long run, it will affect their self-esteem, and we don't want that.
Okay. All right, so what's the first thing we should do, and when should we start it? So I noticed probably at age one, you know, that my child doesn't want to be carried by someone else or go and play with other kids, right?
Okay.
So what's the first thing I should do?
So children have photographic memory.
Wow.
Yes, they do. So prior to any event or prior to them meeting anyone, start showing it to show them. Maybe on your phone, you have the pictures. Oh, look, this is auntie, so it's a person.
Okay.
See, look at that, she's such a nice person. Or prior to the event, let them know that there's going to be a party and you're going to have so much fun. And you're just going to have so much fun. Keep tell them 2-3 days before the event, 2-3 days before meeting anyone.
Okay.
And also, if there's anyone that'll be at that event that they know and are familiar with, let them know that, okay, so person will be at the event, you'll have so much fun, she'll be your friend, you know, just to warm them up.
Okay.
And let them see that, okay, I think I'll enjoy this party or the event.
All right, so it's like prepping them.
Yes,
or,
exactly.
Or pre-informing them.
Yes.
Okay, giving them notice.
Yes, and also, we parents tend to be overprotective, and it's not good. So if you're overprotective of your child at any event or anywhere, you're indirectly telling that child that the environment is toxic.
Or the environment, not safe.
Yes, it's not safe. So you're only encouraging that shy behavior in them. So it's important that we're not overprotective and we're not authoritarians. Like, sit down there, don't go there. It's also very important.
Okay, so now, if for instance I'm at an event, let's say a wedding now, there's no way I'm gonna let that child run around in between tables, knocking into waiters. I'm gonna be at least protective to an extent to keep them safe.
Yes.
You know, that's the first thing on my mind. Mm-hmm. Don't go missing, don't touch something that could harm you, or go and trip on a wire or something like that, just because I want them to be free. But I don't know what alternative you would suggest. Maybe in some other situation, maybe at the park or something like
that. Yes, at the park. That is where prepping comes in.
Okay.
You let them know, okay, so you're going to the park. Mm-hmm. Let them know in a very subtle way that going far away from mommy, straying away from mommy can be very dangerous.
Okay.
But in a very subtle way. You won't have to make it too scary for them. Mm-hmm. So that way they'll know that, okay, so this is where I should play. This is, mommy is over there, I'm right here, so it's okay for me to play here while mommy is over there.
Okay. Mm. So other kids also tend to be shy. And I have noticed with mine that sometimes they try to mirror what they see with other children. So if, for instance, my girls meet shy kids, what do you think I should encourage them to do?
Okay, if your child is someone that is very open, and is she very open?
No, so I'm just assuming that my child is shy at this point and meets another shy child. You know, so I'm thinking they might just be mirroring the attitudes that they see. I don't know if that makes sense.
Well, the thing is, shy kids and another shy kid tend to like each other.
Oh.
Yes.
Wow. Okay. Okay.
They will kind of warm up to each other, but in their own way. You know, they won't, compared to a child that is very, very verbal and all, they won't go in that that route, but they would at least say hello. Hello, how are you? Okay. And just sit beside each other.
And they'll be there quiet,
yes,
together.
Together.
But are you sure I shouldn't discourage that? Maybe tell the child to go somewhere else. I don't know. What's my next move?
The next move is for you to come there and talk to the both of them. Okay. Oh, you have a new friend. What's your friend's name? Did you ask? What's your name? Mm. Ask, what's your name? Mm-hmm. How are you? How old are you? Mm. You know, you have to strike that conversation. You help your child strike the conversation, start the conversation.
Okay.
And then from there, she'll pick it up.
Mm. So there are probably kids that are a lot older that are probably going through this. So let's say they're age 7 to 10 years old now.
Mm.
Now they've already formed their own manners. There's really not much I believe that you can do at that point.
Mm.
But this child, let's stick to toddlers as we started with toddlers. Let's say 5, 6 years old now.
Okay.
They've already started forming their own attitudes, mannerisms, and maybe a parent has actually missed it that this child is shy.
Mm.
So what do you think they can do to remedy the situation?
At that point, you have to, children see, children do. At that point, you have to emulate what you want your child to do.
Okay.
You have to keep doing it in front of him.
Mm.
At gatherings, you say hello to people, and then there is no way that child won't say hello to maybe one person.
Okay.
And when he or she does, praise that child, it goes a long way.
All right.
Then you say, oh, you said hello to such a person. Oh, that's really, really nice. I mean, that's really good. Did you ask his name or her name? I mean, that's really good. It helps their self-confidence. It boosts the self-confidence.
I'm always afraid that it's something the parents have done in the past that makes these children shy.
Yes.
For instance, telling the children to shut up, don't go there.
Yes.
Actually, really hammering down, like dropping the hammer
that's,
on
that's
these
been
children.
An authoritarian,
yes.
And it's really, like I mentioned earlier, that it's one of the factors that actually cause, that actually increases the shy behavior in these kids, and they won't change if you keep doing that. So it's really important that we don't verbally abuse our kids or ridicule them, or try to say, oh, look at your sister, or compare them to other kids. It's wrong. It should not be done. We should try as much as possible not to compare, not to verbally abuse them or talk down on them in any way.
Okay, all right. Hopefully a parent out there is hearing this and understands exactly what you're saying. So if, for instance, a parent has been telling the child to shut up, they have inherently created a shy child.
Yes, yes, in a way.
So there are a lot of shy adults out there. Are we saying that the shyness probably started from when they were toddlers?
Yes. Mm. I used to be.
Oh,
yes,
really?
Yes, I used to be.
Okay.
So it actually started, my parents are authoritarians to an extent.
Okay.
So I feel that it actually started from then. Till now, and it grew into anxiety such that when I go anywhere, I'll start feeling, oh, this place is, I should not be here. Let me just go to mommy or go to daddy or stay in a quiet place where no one will see me. And then it would definitely affect your self-esteem. You won't be brave or bold to say anything out there.
All right. Thank you so much. I think we've about covered it. But I know that, you know, there's probably a parent out there that is also shy. So if you're a shy parent,
please, do you
expect your child to also be shy like you? I don't know.
Well, not all kids are as shy as their parents. Some parents are shy and then the kids will just emulate and also be. But then some won't even go that way and will want to be their own person.
All right, then. Thank you so much, Modupe, for coming to the show once again.
Thank you for having me.